Hey homeowners, I hope you are having an inspiring day. This is, wait, I think I'm out of focus. Let me just fix that real quick. And there you go. Hey homeowners, I hope you are having an inspiring day. This is Jen, your MF Home TV guest host for today. And before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and tap the notification bell below so that you won't miss out any of their new uploads, just like this one. So today I am going to share to you guys 5 renter-friendly decorating tips. And since I am not an expert in terms of interior designing, that is why what I'm going to share today is based on my personal experience as a renter. So I have been renting for 8 years now, all throughout my working life. And the reason why I'm renting, it's because my hometown is way too far from my workplace. So before, I kept on traveling from Cebu City to Karkar City. And just to give you an idea of how far it is, usually the travel time is around 1 hour, but if there is the traffic, it will take me 1 hour and 30 minutes. Worse, it's 2 hours. So during the first month of me working as a call center agent, nag-uuwian ako, so I need to travel from Cebu City to Karkar. And there's this one incident wherein, when I was inside the bus, so I was so exhausted from work, natulog ako sa loob ng bus, guys. And then after that, when I woke up, I was actually now at the next municipality where I live. So that is the turning point for me, and that is when I decided, oh my god, this shouldn't be the case. I need to rent a place inside the city or in the city. So that is when my renter life began. So eventually, I learned to live this way, the renter way, and I learned the process of decision making in terms of buying things inside my small space, the do's and don'ts, to which I'll be more than happy to share that to you today, guys. So let's get started before the sun sets. First on our list, guys, is maximize your small space with the right furniture. And I think this is the most basic one and something that every renter should remember. So you have to buy a few items, but the right furniture. Say for example, in my place, it's a pretty small space, so I don't really have an area for my living room. So what I did was I got a sofa bed wherein it works as a sofa by day and a bed by night. I also got a chest of drawers with mirrors on it as part of its design, and it's super stylish yet functional. It creates an illusion that my room is bigger, plus it bounces the light so that my room is brighter, and it's really ideal for the vlog. And why you should buy few items? It's because renter life is not permanent. You always move in from one place to another. Say for example, what happened to me, guys. So before, I was renting in Cebu. Then when I became a flight attendant, I need to transfer to Manila. And when I transferred to Manila, I was based back again in Cebu. And when I got in Cebu after a year, I was based back in Manila. So there's a lot of transfer. So that's why it's really important for you to buy few items so that it'll be easier for you to carry them as you move in. And also say no to impulsive buying. You have to study first the items or the furniture that you have to purchase before buying them. If it's ideal for your place, or if it's really functional, or it complements your style. Just like what happened to me, so I'm trying to revamp my kitchen and I saw this dish rack online and immediately purchased it without even thinking or somewhat like measuring my kitchen area. So when I got it, it doesn't really fit, and so I ended up giving it away. And for our second tip, guys, install shelves as part of your additional space decoration. Before, I'm not really a fan of shelves until I got one and I'm really obsessed about it. It's because aside from it's part of your wall decoration because we don't want a boring wall, you may also use it as a space for your favorite stuff like your portrait, your souvenirs, and your favorite family portrait as well. But the downside of it, you really have to ask permission from your landlords because we need to drill the walls. And luckily on my side, they approved it and that was a yay! Down to our third tip, guys, is don't buy expensive home decorations. Number one reason, it's very impractical because as a renter that we are, we kept on moving from one place to another. And also, that piece of home decoration might not complement anymore as we move into a different place. And as time goes by, our style preference also changes, so it might not complement anymore with our new taste. And no matter how beautiful that piece is, no matter how aesthetically pleasing it is, please fight the urge to purchase that because, as what I've mentioned earlier, it's really impractical. And for our fourth tip, just in case that your landlords will not allow repainting your walls or drilling the holes, then the best option would be the wallpaper. So wallpaper instead of repainting. Why? It's because it's less work. It's easy to put on, it's easy to remove if you want to change the style. And at the same time, it actually fills up the empty spaces of your wall. And the best part about it, you'll get to see or you'll get to showcase your personality through the wallpapers. And the last but not the least, guys, bring life to your space with houseplants. So just recently, I turned a plantita. So I took a lot of indoor plants. No, not really a lot of, like a couple of indoor plants in my own little space. And the reason why, and that's the best decision so far. Why? It's because aside from it's really therapeutic and it's a good breather, it's a nice thing that you have something to take care of inside your space, knowing that I am just by myself all of the time. And every time that I'm editing a vlog and I want to somewhat like refresh my eyes, I always look to my plants and somehow it gives me that kind of easy feeling. As what I mentioned earlier, it's very therapeutic and it's a good breather. And I guess that's it, guys. I hope you learned a lot, but just a disclaimer, all of the tips that I provided are just based on my personal experience, so it might not be applied to you, but it's a good to know. And thank you for joining me in this video. I had so much fun. Renter life can be exciting, sometimes crazy, but most of all, it jumpstarts you to the adulting life. Agree? Let me know in the comment section. And thank you so much, Mandawi Foam, for having me. I truly enjoyed it. Thank you for giving me the chance and sharing my personal experiences in terms of renting. And please do support them by subscribing to their channel, like this video, and share this to your friend who are currently renting, but hopefully soon, a homeowner. Once again, this is Jen, inspiring your home.
Comment of the week. Congratulations to last week's winner. This week's prize.